And now we have Walder Frey, who was one of the most loathed people in all the Seven Kingdoms. He is, of course, Lord of the Crossing, Lord of Riverrun, Paramount of the Trident, and just overall a general douche. This is the guy who makes alliances just across whatever, just as long as they're benefiting from him. He marries his kids off, again, just if it benefits him. He cares nothing about the future, even of his own house, and will turn traitorous on anyone at any time, as long as the pay is good enough. He is the architect of the Red Wedding, which is one of the most important moments in the Game of Thrones series so far, or significant moments. And after he betrays, initially he betrays House Tully, who he is actually a vassal for. So he has a relationship with Catelyn Tully that's supposed to even go beyond what his relationship with the Stark House was. He quickly wipes that away in lieu of being supported by the Lannister family. And they're going to give him all this land, which they do, and now he is the Lord of Riverrun. He's very content with himself. He is known for his cowardice in a world where the men are, especially the kings, the lords, are the ones who are brave and fight. So that's why he gets so much scorn. And he makes, of course, the alliance with Roose Bolton when they turn on the Starks and marries one of his daughter, Fat Walder Frey, off to Roose Bolton to secure that alliance that they have between those two houses. And for his fat daughter, he gives Roose her weight in silver, which is a lot of money because his daughter is a big one, right? And this guy is just kind of disgusting in every single way. He doesn't, he uses people to do this killing for him, but he wants to take this pride and see himself as a conqueror. But he knows that the other houses are laughing at him, and that just fills him with this rage. So he feels justified in his types of his betrayal. But the great thing about Walder Frey is how he dies. He, of course, is on Arya Stark's list. And she sneaks in, and using one of the masks that she stole from her training with the Many-Faced Gods, she actually kills two of his sons and puts them in a pie that she feeds him. Allows him to eat for a little while before revealing what he's actually eating. And this little girl, who must be like 13, strikes fear in the heart of this old, decrepit 95-year-old man to the point that he attempts to run from her because he's such a coward. And she catches him because Arya is nice with the steel nowadays, and she slits his throat, and that is the end of Walder Frey. He does have a lot of children, so his house is not dead, but we'll see if his house plays a more significant role or a continued role as the story continues. But again, to Walder Frey, I would spit on you if you were here. That's what I really think about you. You're just a disgusting person. Only Crassus is maybe more disgusting than you, because at least you didn't sleep with your own daughters. But geez, man, any other young girl, you're a 95-year-old man, you got a young wife. What do you think that's like for her? Anyway, I'm getting a little personal about Walder Frey, but you don't have to get personal with it, because I'll break it down for you. Just give us a like and give us a share, and stop back as we talk more Game of Thrones.